Hi everyone, Ranger Kendra here with this week's session of Alaska Maritime National Wildlife Refuge's virtual science lesson. And so last week we talked a little bit about just how big Alaska Maritime Refuge really is. It spans all across the coastlines and islands of Alaska, all the way from Southeast Alaska, all the way up to the northwest corner in the Chukchi Sea. We also talked about the main type of wildlife that our research biologists study, and those are seabirds. Seabirds really help us to understand the ocean habitats. We can get a good idea of the health of the ocean by studying these birds. And because Alaska Maritime Refuge is so big, we have to divide it up into sections or research units. And we have a total of 5 research units. Now, last week, one of our research biologists, Mark, shared about a very special bird that he studies within his research unit. So we talked about the thick-billed murre, and he studies within the Bering Sea and the Chukchi Sea unit. So this week, I've got another very special biologist that is going to share with you about a very cool and fun bird that she studies within her research unit, which is the Gulf of Alaska unit. And we're gonna go all the way over to Southeast Alaska, where this really fun bird who has a really interesting name calls home. And so without further ado, I'm going to introduce Brie so she can tell us all about the Rhinoceros Auklet.
Hi, I'm Brie. I'm a wildlife biologist overseeing the Gulf of Alaska region of our refuge. And today I'm going to tell you about a really neat nocturnal seabird that breeds in Alaska, the rhinoceros auklet. So rhinoceros auklets are more closely related to puffins than auklets, but they get their name because they have this big white horn on top of their bill that makes them look like a rhinoceros. Now, rhinoceros auklets breed in southern Alaska and British Columbia and Washington, so not in the northern area, in western areas of Alaska, in the Bering Sea and Aleutian Islands. The colony that I'm going to tell you a little bit about today is on St. Lazaria Island. It's in southeast Alaska, about 10 miles off the coast of Sitka. It's covered in trees, so tall spruce trees with really thick undergrowth, thick foliage, and fairly thick soil for some of the burrow nesting birds who dig holes to breed in. So rhinoceros auklets nest underground, and they dig deep winding tunnels into the ground. When you're standing at a rhinoceros auklet colony during the daytime, all you see is holes in the ground. So it's kind of like standing on top of Swiss cheese, and the ground is very fragile. If you are stepping where their burrows are, you can easily crush them. They dig using their bills and claws, and at the end of the tunnel, there's usually a little wider area to have some vegetation lining the nest where they lay their eggs. And they reuse the same burrow year after year. So once they dig a burrow, they don't have to do that separately each year. Now, rhinoceros auklets lay just one egg a year. It's about the size of a chicken egg, generally just white. And it's about 2/3 the size of a murre egg. They are nocturnal at the colony. So that means that during the day, when you're standing on the colony, you don't really see or hear any birds. The birds are offshore feeding at night, and they come back to the colony only after dark and to socialize and to feed their chicks then. At the colony at night, it's really noisy with thousands of birds flying around, making lots of different vocalizations. The most common vocalization that rhinoceros auklets makes is a very distinctive low mooing noise. The sound which sounds kind of like that's how they communicate to each other and also to their chicks. Rhinoceros auklets eat mostly fish. They do also consume some squid and invertebrates. And they dive into the water and swim with their wings underwater to catch fish. They generally, we consider them as kind of mid-depth diving seabirds. Typically, they swim to about 30 to 60 feet deep. So not quite as deep as some of our other seabirds, such as murres, which can go quite a bit further. They carry fish back to the colony at night in their bills for their chicks to eat. And rhinoceros auklets in the summertime look fairly impressive with, again, this white horn, a bright orange bill, and these white plumes, feathers coming off of their heads. In the winter, however, they look very different. They lose all that ornamentation. So their bills turn kind of a beige or black, and they lose a horn on their bill and the white head feathers. They will regain it again at the beginning of each breeding season. And during the winter, they pretty much just go offshore. They don't have a long winter migration like some seabird species. And they just hang out in the open water and come back to the colony in the spring again to raise another round of chicks. So that's a little bit of information about this really neat bird of ours in Alaska on our refuge. I hope you enjoyed learning some facts about the rhinoceros auklet today, and have a good day.